Here are some of the most polluted places in the world. Number 10. North Pacific Gyre. The Pacific Ocean is famously the largest ocean in the world at a span measuring over 63.8 million square miles. Let me first explain to those who don't know what a gyre is. An ocean gyre is a system of currents that sticks to a course and can flow in exactly the same location and direction. Isn't nature an amazing thing? As you'd imagine, if an object is left stranded in one of these, it'll be carried with this current for many, many years. Because of this current in the North Pacific Gyre, this area, that's also known as the Pacific Trash Vortex, makes the list. The North Pacific Gyre is home to the world's largest pile of garbage, and is topped off regularly by garbage from the ocean's western garbage pile. Located off the coast of Japan, the Pacific Trash Vortex can be seen off the shores between California and Hawaii. The floating cloud of trash is comprised mainly of man-made marine debris collected over the years of sea exploration and was first discovered as early as 1985. The size of the patch is unknown because large items readily visible from, say, a boat deck are uncommon. Most debris consists of small plastic particles suspended at or just below the surface, making it difficult to accurately detect by aircraft or satellite. The sheer scale of this patch hasn't yet been accurately measured, but we can safely say it covers at least a few miles. Estimates of its size range from 270,000 square miles, which is about the size of Texas, to more than 5.8 million square miles, or about 8% of the size of the Pacific Ocean. Number 9. SUKINDA, India. Are you familiar with something called the hexavalent chromium? If not, basically it's a man-made heavy metal and is used in the production of stainless steel products and leather tanning. The vital ingredient in giving these materials their strength is the metal element known as chromium. In September 2007, the Blacksmith Institute listed SUKINDA as one of the 10 most polluted places in the world. However, multiple local political figures and scientists disputed the listing, claiming that the Blacksmith Institute used outdated research. Anyways, this particular Indian town has factories that make the products mentioned, as well as the world's largest and highly exposed chromite ore mine, all of which pollute the air with toxic fumes that are constantly inhaled. 60% of the drinking water in the area contains hexavalent chromium, which is more than double the international acceptance. What's more interesting is that Indian health officials estimate that 84.5% of mine-related deaths are linked to chromium-related diseases. Supposedly, so far, nothing has been done to improve living and working conditions or to combat the level of pollution. Number 8. Kalimantan, Indonesia. Kalimantan, found on the Indonesian island of Borneo, is home to many infamous small-scale gold mines. Gold is extracted and smelted down using the highly toxic metal mercury. Kalimantan is composed of 5 provinces. In 2 of those provinces, central and south, artisanal small-scale gold mining forms the primary source of income for 43,000 people. Workers and nearby locals are exposed daily to the poisonous fumes of mercury. The fumes contaminate local waterways, and because of this, surrounding vegetation suffers. Mercury vapors can travel long distances in the atmosphere. However, the most acute health risks posed by these mines are more local in nature. What's even more shocking is that some miners even carry out this dangerous work in their family homes. This leads to the mercury fumes becoming trapped in their homes and slowly spreading illness between them and their families. Additionally, mercury released during the amalgamation process before smelting is easily released into area waterways where it can accumulate in fish and water. Thankfully, since a survey was carried out in 2008 exposing the rising rate of mercury-related deaths, Indonesian governments have taken steps to gradually abandon the use of mercury and make the gold mining and smelting process safer. Number 7. AGBOGBLOSHIE, ACCRA, Ghana. AGBOGBLOSHIE is the name of a trash dump. Sure, no big surprise a dump site would be mentioned on this list, except things are a bit different for this particular site. Found in Ghana's capital city of Accra, AGBOGBLOSHIE is contributing to a dangerously toxic atmosphere throughout the area. This site is used mainly for discarding of what's known as e-waste, which, as you can imagine, basically means electronic garbage. Unfortunately, extracting the valuable metals from e-waste consists of burning the rubbers and plastics protecting it. The mass scale of burning of these materials causes toxic vapors and leads to a highly polluted environment. Poisons such as lead, mercury, and arsenic seep into the surrounding soil and water, thereby seriously polluting the landscape. The burning of plastics and rubbers is carried out with no protective clothing or breathing apparatus and is all carried out in the open air. Greenpeace Labs tests have shown the water and soil from areas in AGBOGBLOSHIE contained concentrations of toxins at levels 100 times more than the allowable amount. Several studies have confirmed high levels of lead in the soil with particular risk to workers and children. Supposedly, workers in these scrap yards have been reported to only living to their mid-20s after short careers consisting of long days of nausea, breathing problems, untreated wounds and burns, anorexia, and inevitable cancer. Just wow. Exposure to these toxic fumes is especially hazardous to children, as these toxins are known to inhibit the development of the reproductive system, the nervous system, and the brain in particular. High levels of toxins have also been discovered in soil and food samples, as these chemicals stay in the food chain. Number 6. Mediterranean Sea. Surrounded by highly populated locations and dense tourism of Southern Europe and Northern Africa, it's no wonder the Mediterranean Sea is an entry on this video. Underneath the idyllic appearance of the Mediterranean lies evidence of terribly filthy human behavior. Underwater pipes gush out gallons and gallons of untreated sewage into the sea each year, 650 million tons to be exact. In addition to the sewage, 60,000 tons of toxic mercury and 4,000 tons of lead are also dumped here, along with an estimated 129,000 tons of mineral oil, and just to top it off, piles and piles of domestic waste and debris. It goes without saying that the Mediterranean water has become highly contaminated and become extremely dangerous to wildlife and beachgoers. Sadly, for its size, the Mediterranean Sea is classed as the most polluted sea in the world. This issue has been raised with the UN many times. However, with the sheer scale and the huge amounts of contributors to the pollution, it's hard to know where to begin. Number 5. Buriganga River, Bangladesh. The mighty Buriganga River, responsible for feeding and supplying the Bangladeshi capital of Dhaka, is now threatening thousands of locals as it's now the most polluted river in Bangladesh. Industrial waste such as oil, metallic particles, and human waste, including untreated sewage, now dominates the city's waterways and are causing a life-threatening level of toxins. Environmental experts say that the river was once a highly reliable source of energy and fuel to the people, wildlife, and the general city of Dhaka. Really, it took environmental experts to figure that one out? According to the Dhaka Water and Sewerage Authority, about 420,000 cubic feet of untreated waste are released every day. Textile industries annually discharge as much as 56 million tons of waste and a half million ton of sludge. Sewage is also released into the Buriganga. Because of Dhaka's heavy reliance on river transport for goods, including food, the Buriganga receives especially high amounts of food waste since unusable or rotting portions of fruits, vegetables, and fish are just thrown into the river. The waterway is simply used by industry giants for nothing else but as a place to dump their chemical and metallic waste. It's been said that the pollution has become so bad that any living organism within the river has died out. In a wide stretch of the river, the contents of the water have turned the river into a stream of what's described as a thick, black, gel-like consistency. As a result, local lives have been put at risk due to their reliance on this major waterway, with malnutrition taking effect and a spread of diseases infecting many who rely on its water. Number 4. La Oroya, Peru. This longtime mining town in Peru suffers with an atmosphere highly clogged with toxic fumes. Peru's very own clean air campaigners have listed the town as being in critical condition. Dangerous smelting and constructing a polymetallic products are carried out in the town's giant U.S.-owned plant, Do Run Peru, which pumps out large amounts of harmful lead. Along with the harmful lead, 27,000 parts of sulfur dioxide are also pumped into the air for the citizens to breathe in. As a result of years of pollution, the hills immediately around the smelting operations have become completely barren. The river became more toxic, and the health of area inhabitants suffered. Residents have been found to have alarmingly high concentrations of lead in their blood and in the drinking water, and many have bronchial troubles. A 1999 study showed high levels of air pollution in La Oroya, with 85 times more arsenic, 41 more times cadmium, and 13 times more lead than amounts generally considered safe. Number 3. Niger Delta, Nigeria. The Niger Delta is at the heart of Nigeria's oil industry, as 2 million barrels of oil are sourced by the mines every single day. So, it's unsurprising that there are side effects from producing oil near a water source. The Department of Petroleum Resources estimated 1.89 million barrels of petroleum were spilled into the Niger Delta between 1976 and 1996 in 4,835 incidents. However, reports on the extent of the oil spills vary. A United Nations Development Program report states that there have been a total of 6,817 oil spills between 1976 and 2001, which account for a loss of 3 million barrels of oil, of which more than 70% was not recovered. Anyways, spillages, fires, and contaminations are commonplace and obviously take a huge effect. The oil pollution in the water can be seen for miles. A huge rainbow decorates the river's surface, while a majority of the river's water is left black. The spillage has a major impact on the ecosystem, as immense tracts of mangrove forests, which are especially susceptible to oil, have been destroyed. The rainforest that previously occupied some 2,800 square miles of land has disappeared as well. Wow, that's just insane. Spills in populated areas often spread out over a wide area, destroying crops and aquacultures through contamination of the groundwater and soils. The consumption of dissolved oxygen by bacteria feeding on the spilled hydrocarbons also contributes to the death of fish. In agricultural communities, often a year's supply of food can be destroyed instantaneously. Because of the careless nature of oil operations in the Delta, the environment is growing increasingly uninhabitable. Number 2. LINFEN, China. Found in the Shanxi province in northeast China, LINFEN is argued as the most polluted city in the world. A massive coal mines opened in the city in 1978, and ever since then, coal has been highly sought after by everyone around. Coal is still the leader in fuel choices for many places, and it's not any different for this city, as coal is still dominant in the city. Because of the pollution, there has been an increase in cases of pneumonia and bronchitis, not to mention a huge rise in lung cancer being reported in local hospitals. However, from its low point in 2004, with only 15 days out of the year with an acceptable level of air pollution, the environmental situation has improved in LINFEN. After a series of negative reports on the extreme level of pollution in the city, efforts were made to clean up the air. Substandard mines were closed, coal trucks were kept from entering the city, resulting in much less coal dust. The city also switched much of its heating sources from coal to gas. 197 large coal-fired boilers and more than 600 smaller boilers were decommissioned. Number 1. Chernobyl Exclusion Zone. There's simply no escaping it. Chernobyl is simply the most contaminated and dangerously polluted place in the world. In 1986, Chernobyl's nuclear power station disastrously blew up because of faulty nuclear reactors. Because of the magnitude of the radioactive blast, farmland as far as the UK were even contaminated by a rain of nuclear fallout. The exclusion zone covers an area of approximately 1,000 square miles in Ukraine, which immediately surrounds the Chernobyl nuclear power plant, where radioactive contamination from fallout is highest and public access and inhabitation are restricted. The radiation level in Ground Zero is still very much at a critical level and can potentially cause mass radiation poisoning and cancer. The exclusion zone's purpose is to restrict access to hazardous areas, reduce the spread of radiological contamination, and conduct radiological and ecological monitoring activities. The pollution within the zone is so bad that it's supposedly completely uninhabitable, and recent studies are still showing signs of mutations in bugs and wildlife that live nearby. However, the zone is estimated to be home to 197 people living in 11 villages. The numbers is in decline, down from the previous estimate of 314 in 2007 and 1,200 in 1986. These residents are senior citizens with an average age of 63. After many attempts at expulsion, Ukraine authorities became reconciled to their presence and have allowed them limited supporting services. Residents are now informally permitted to stay by the Ukrainian government. Today, the exclusion zone remains one of the most radioactively contaminated areas in the world and draws significant scientific interest of the high levels of radiation exposure in the environment, as well as increasing interest from tourists. Seriously, who would want to visit? Here's what's next. Perilous job possibly tops almost all mentioned in this list. Really, this should be number 1B. Sewage diving is a well-known job in all corners of the globe. If there's a blockage or a broken drain, someone's got to get down there and sort it out, just like that diver in Australia. The difference being, though, most sewage divers...